curve line. Now we're going to set up how to practice it. So I've got two tees, still got the quarters down, because we're going to make a gate around the apex of the break that the ball has to travel through to stay on its line and seeing it curve into the hole.
Yeah, this probably be a good one, like around the third quarter or something.
We'll put it kind of in between the third.
Okay.
Because I see it curving right before it gets to the third.
I got you.
That gives me a range for distance.
Okay.
Depending on how long the putt. If you got like a 30 footer, you can give yourself like 4 feet.
Okay.
But I'm going to put it on the line, so that gives me a range of how far I want to hit. So I can see the curve, the quarters coming back. Does that look about right?
Yeah, I got you.
Yeah.
That's cool. So like that's like at most, you don't want it to go past that.
Right. That's matching the speed to the line.
Okay.
We'll keep this process for the driver.
Okay.
It's going to be the same for irons.
Okay.
So bad. Obviously, we're on a driving range here, but this specific one only has one target.
Okay.
Imagining there are multiple targets out on the driving range. Move around to different ones.
Mm-hmm.
Try to avoid going to a target straight perpendicular to the tee box.
Okay.
Because when you're out on the course, your lines aren't always going to be that clear.
Right.
Cut. Perpendicular and parallel. So trying to go to targets, try to balance it. I want to go to targets left of the tee box.
Okay.
I want to go to target to the right of where the tee box lines up.
Yeah, because some of those like range markers are like the full board. So it's like, okay, I got some good lines. You see what you're saying?
Right. You're not training your eyes to see the correct line if you're lying on a shot straight off of the range.
Okay.
With that, I'm going to line these up what would be parallel to that white board on the range.
Okay.
Starting with the ball line, I'm gonna set it, comfortable distance outside the ball line so that you're not gonna think about the club hitting it.
Okay.
And this is not to go dead on your feet. It's just a reference point.
Okay.
I'm gonna make railroad tracks, just like we did with putting, slightly inside the foot line. When you were doing putting, we had that blue line to help you line up the ball and to help you line up the sticks too.
Mm-hmm.
Your blue line is going to be your golf club now.
Okay.
I want to get the sticks parallel to one another, and sometimes we'll come around here. We'll look.
Yeah.
I don't have too many imperfections in the carpet to be able to pick something.
Right.
Does that look about right?
What are you going for? Just the right down the ball line?
Parallel to the mat.
Yeah.
Okay. So my blue line is going to be this shaft.
Okay.
I'm going to cover up the ball with the shaft.
All right.
I'm going to tilt it up.
All right.
And when I do that, I'm left eye dominant, which you are too, right?
Yeah.
My right eye is going to be closed, my left eye open.
Okay.
I'm going to get the shaft parallel to the lines.
Uh-huh.
When I get it there, I'm going to look up.
Okay.
When I look up, I want it at my target.
Okay.
I'm going to drop it, and when I drop it, I'll find my little piece. So when I held that up there, it didn't match.
It's a little off?
Yeah, it was a little bit right. So this is a process that you can use on the golf course, too, to get your alignment. Hold the shaft up. You obviously won't have the parallel lines, but you will have that shaft to point at your target, whether it's a tree, that specific target that we want.
Right.
And I'm going to drop it. When I drop it, find a piece somewhere like 3 to 5 feet in front of the ball.
Okay.
The lines look good to me. They're real parallel. If the lines were off and my stick were at my target, I'd have to fix the alignment rod while I'm on the driving range. Drop it. And once I drop it, then walk into the shot.
Okay. Do the whole routine from there.
Yeah.
Okay.
To help you save some grass where you're not moving it when you're on the range, if you got an iron, start at the front of them and then move back so that your divots aren't in your way.
Okay. Yeah.
If you start at the back of the middle, you're going to lose space to hit because your divots are going to be in the way.
Okay.
Yeah. All right. So, club up in front. The ball should be somewhere under the shaft.
Okay. Line it up with this, the alignment rods?
Yeah. Do the alignment rods look pretty parallel to the club?
Absolutely.
Okay. When you drop it, you should see that roughly in line.
Yep.
Yeah. Now this won't, you won't be able to move it, you'll just find something on it.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
It's definitive.
But making this part of your process in your practice will bleed into your routine in a full swing.
Cool. Rather than just going out on the range hitting balls for
right.
nothing.